right here on TSN. You want to talk about title matches? The High Flyers, Greg Gagne and Jim Brunzell against the Road Warriors. Greg, come on in if you would, please. It's a shot that I know you've been waiting for. You had a tough 1984. Now you got the Road Warriors.
Well, we definitely did have a tough 1984 because of Sheik Adnan El-Kaisi and one King Kong Brody who laid me up for 8 months with a knee injury and surgery on the knee. Jim and I are back together now. We have had an opportunity to wrestle the Road Warriors, so we proved to everybody throughout Canada and throughout the world that we could beat this team. And if it wouldn't have been for one man, Paul Ellering, Jim and I would be the World Tag Team Champions right now. So, Larry, we've been training very, very hard for this match. We've got another week yet, and by next week, we're going to gear it up. And by the end of the week, we'll have that psych there, and we'll step in with these two men and hopefully take the titles away from them. It won't be any easy task. We know that.
Nobody questions the ability of the High Flyers. That would be ludicrous. But these are very big, powerful men. Any special strategy?
Stay away from their strength. Stay away from that upper body. They both have tremendous upper body strength. We've seen them beat a lot of opponents with that press slam that they use where they catch the man, press him over their head, and you're coming down from about 7-8 feet in the air, and it knocks the wind out of you, and from there they come down with those elbows and knees and whatever. So we'll stay away from them. We'll keep moving, try to make them wrestle our style match, and hopefully we can win this one.
Keep an eye on Paul Ellering. Greg, thank you for being here. Next week, the High Flyers versus the Road Warriors on TSN. Coming up in moments, right here on TSN, a battle that I have been waiting for a long time, so have a lot of people. Nobody has been waiting for this one any longer than the High Flyers. Greg Gagne and Jim Brunzell will leave this interview and go challenge the Road Warriors for the Tag Team Championship of the World. Jim, it's been a long time.
It sure has. It's up to us right now. We have our own destiny in hands. A lot of people have been talking about whether or not the High Flyers come back, the same High Flyers. Well, I think we proved to them one time before that we can go in the ring and use our style of teamwork and defeat the Road Warriors. It's not going to be easy, but nothing has ever been easy for the High Flyers.
Greg Gagne, how is the knee? Are you ready? Are you 100%?
We're ready for this one, Larry. We've been warming up, and in just a few minutes, we're stepping in the ring with people call the most devastating team of professional wrestling.
Right.
In the history of professional wrestling, the Road Warriors. Well, on the marquee, it still reads, for the benefit of all those non-believers, professional wrestling. Wrestling is the name of the game. It's not weightlifting. The big muscles, they do help. The strength does help. But if you can only go 10 or 15 minutes with it, it doesn't help a whole heck of a lot. And that's our strategy tonight, to step in there and wear these two men down. We've been in with bodybuilders before, big men. Strong men, maybe not as strong as these two, but after 10 or 15 minutes, Larry, if we can dictate the style of the match, I'll tell you what, those muscles will get so tight they won't be able to straighten those arms out. And then they become a burden to those two people. And that's when we're going in for the kill. We're going in for one purpose, and that's to win the World's Heavyweight Championship, which we've held on two different occasions. Well, Jim and I were laid up this summer with injuries and surgery. We watched the Road Warriors capture the World's Tag Team Championship. We watched Rick Martel win the World's Heavyweight Championship. Now that is eating us inside because it would have been our opportunity to go for those championships. We will not let this one slip by. And Paul Ellering, you keep your nose out of this one this time. Otherwise, the two of us are going to take it right off your face.
That is the problem that shouldn't be. What are you going to do about Paul Ellering? How do you watch the Road Warriors and keep your eye on Paul Ellering?
Well, if we're going to be successful, we're going to have to concentrate on the Road Warriors. We're going to have to let the referee and the commission that's going to be sitting there in the championship committee watch Paul Ellering. You know, he comes out here and he says his men are gods. They might be good at what they've done in the past. Like Greg said, they're very, very strong. But the name of the game, like Greg said, is wrestling. Paul Ellering, keep your nose out of it. Let's see how good your big bodybuilders are when it comes to wrestling and tag team wrestling, something that Greg and I have done for 8.5 years and have been world tag team champions twice. We're going to make it a third time.
Better believe it.
Good luck to the High Flyers. That one is coming up. They're on their way to the arena to meet the Road Warriors.
Gentlemen, this bout, one fall, a 60-minute time limit. For the Tag Team Championship of the World, your referee, Joe Fiorino.
tag team champions of the world. A combined weight of 565 pounds. Accompanied by their manager, Precious Paul Ellering, the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors. And the challengers. First of all, at 234 pounds, out of White Bear Lake, Minnesota, here's Jumpin' Jim Brunzell. And his partner, at 217 pounds, out of Mound, Minnesota, Greg Gagne, the High Flyers, 1-4-60, the Tag Team Championship of the World, Wally Carver.
Attention, Wally Carbo said they had a surprise in store for the Road Warriors, and here it is. Precious Paul Ellering will not be allowed to be in their corner. Paul Ellering is barred from ringside.
It's a bunch of bullshit.
Wally Carbo has just said Precious Paul Ellering will not be allowed at ringside. The Road Warriors putting the Tag Team Championship on the line against the High Flyers. And Wally Carbo has said Paul Ellering has got to leave ringside. Ellering, as expected, is going insane.
Get up.
Well, I'll tell you, Larry Nelson, you talk about a bombshell. Uh-oh. Here they go, the Road Warriors.
Not happy about their manager not being allowed at ringside.
They have been called the most devastating tag team in the history of wrestling. And you can make that point, believe me.
Has got to literally have the Road Warriors totally upset, their whole game plan thrown out of whack. Suddenly, Paul Ellering, who they depend upon for so very many things, and you know exactly what I'm talking about, it's not here at ringside. All week, all their training, your preparation, you might as well throw it right out the window.
Absolute chaos from the very beginning. Now it has finally settled down. Only two men are in the ring like it's supposed to be. That's Hawk. Hawk at 275 pounds. Greg Gagne giving up a lot of weight. Greg goes about 217. But give the agility to the High Flyer. Hawk is in trouble. Spinning toho by Brunzell. Look at him working that hamstring and the knee all at once. They tag again. Greg off the second rope. They're not letting Hawk go anywhere. Here comes Brunzell.
Now, Larry, this is the High Flyers trademark, that rapid fire tagging off, that tremendous teamwork. That's how they're able to overcome teams that are bigger and stronger than they are. And, oh, no team in wrestling tags off and uses teamwork better than the High Flyers, Gagne and Brunzell.
That may well be, but let me tell you about the Road Warriors trademark, and that's raw power. And here comes the 290-pound animal. Hawk desperately needed a tag out, and he made it. If there are any better, if there is any better tag team anywhere in the world than these two, you got to prove it to me. If Boy, what a contrast. Speed and agility against raw power. Look at that. Look at the animal. I mean, he's toying with it. From 10 feet in the air.
Greg Gagne, you're very lucky he was able to have enough sense to roll out of the way and avoid that flying leg drop.
Now they got Animal in the corner, and here comes Brunzell. It looks like the strategy, Ken Resnick, is to take the legs away from the big man.
Well, you know, Jim Brunzell, his two trademarks are those flying drop kicks and that figure four leg scissors and that step over goal. There it is. It's just one step away. Now you can see Brunzell almost have the Animal in position right now to clap that figure four on him.
I'll tell you what, the toughest job in Winnipeg Arena right now is the job of the cameraman trying to keep up with the action. Both these teams fly all over the place. And look at this. Animal reaching. Hawk reaching. They made the tag, but I don't think Joe Barrio saw it. No, he's going to run Hawk out of there. Boy, Hawk gets his licks in, but they're going to run him out of there. And now the high flyers have got the Animal in a problem. Going after the legs. You take away the man's legs, that means he's on the mat. And everybody is equal on the mat. Size goes right out the window. I had talked to Greg Gagne and Jim Brunzell just before this match began. They said that was the idea. High gouge, tag off. Brunzell, can he keep him back? Yeah. Greg Gagne, you're going to come in and make sure. They tell you about these high flyers. They don't miss a trick. And now look at Brunzell working on the leg. Now look at the power. Look at the raw power of the Animal. Arms only. And he's digging out of it. Brunzell's got to break the hold and come to his feet to keep him from making the tag.
I'll tell you, Larry, they call themselves the high flyers because both of them are tremendous executing flying head scissors, flying drop kicks. But no team is able to work better on the mat than the high flyers, because if you get a man down onto the mat, that takes away any size and strength advantage you may have.
Look at that. From the second rope again, down on the Animal's leg. You wonder how he can... Now what's coming here? Look at the Animal. He's hurt, but he's fighting. Give these road warriors their due. Down he goes.
Now you see Greg Gagne able to work that around almost into an Indian death lock. Ooh!
Boy, I'll tell you, that wrapped up in an incredible fashion. There's always an extra tinge of excitement when either one of these teams is in a ring. Now when they both are, look at this! Look at the Animal! He's out of it! Tags the Hawk! And now Greg Gagne in trouble. He couldn't get out of there quick enough. He's fighting back. Now they're going power for power. That's not the high flyer game. Yeah. Oh, my. He's at least 10 feet in the air.
Again, Greg Gagne able to roll. That's a pretty good thing he did, Larry.
Greg Gagne has done his homework. He knows that kind of move follows the slam. Oh, no, Bearhug. Come in. Brunzell from the other side.
Well, the high flyers firing a pace out of the Road Warriors. Referee Joe Fiorino distracted, and Jim Brunzell able to sneak in and break that bear hug that the Hawk had on Greg Gagne.
Greg out of the frying pan.
Look at that, the flyer.
Control over. And now.
a trademark of Jim Brunzell, that flying dropkick. And boy, did he connect solidly. Look at Hawk hang on to those ropes. He does not want to go in the center of the ring. Oh, there Brunzell was able to break it. Now that step over to him. There it is. He sets him up for the figure four.
Boy, these teams know what they're doing. The High Flyers have twice held that title. The Road Warriors may be the best in history. Oh. Look at that power slap. Here comes Animal. You think the Hawk is big? Animal, 15 pounds heavier. And when you look at that man's body, it's easy to tell it's all muscle. Brunzell not intimidated. Power slam, nope. Yeah, ooh. Can he get him? About 2.5, Brunzell kicked out of it. Animal still in control. Boy, they're going to bring that camera. Now, you've got the best seat in the house. We can't get anywhere near that close. Look, first of all, if you will, at the pure determination of the Animal. And then, now look at Jim Brunzell. 9 minutes, 30 seconds gone in this match. Now it's a power game, and that should favor the Animal. But look at Brunzell. Look at Brunzell. Hawk comes in. Oh! That punched the ribs. That ought to do it. Hawk in the action now. If you can get a shot of Brunzell's face, he is really in trouble. But he's fighting back with everything he's got. Come on, Jim, get to that corner.
Keep that hand open.
Well, it was not an open hand, and there's no doubt about it. Brunzell went the wrong way, and now he's in a world of trouble. Over there where they can both get at him. The Hawk letting him wander around for a while, stunned and confused, and then putting in a punch on him.
I'll tell you that,
Animal trying to get hold of it.
I don't know for sure if Jim Brunzell even realizes where he is. Well, he's trying now, he's trying to crawl over to tag his partner. The Hawk is got him by the trunk, refusing to let him over for the tag.
Marino makes him break the hold, but it didn't help Brunzell. He is still in the clutches of the Hawk. Jim Brunzell is a very resilient wrestler. He is in excellent condition. He's got a lot of strength, but he desperately needs a tag. You can't keep taking a beating. Look at this man. Look at this Hawk. I mean, look at that pure power. Look at the shoulders. Jumpy Arena again saying, you gotta open that fist. Body slam. Boy, when the Road Warriors body slam you, I don't see how the ring takes it. They are so powerful, but look at Brunzell fight back. He got under him. Oh. What a blow! And he gets in the corner. The Hawk did the first thing he has to do. He's got to get to his feet and try hard to flip out of it. But Gagne is all over him, riding him around like a rodeo cowboy. The Hawk made the rope. Now he's out of the rope. They didn't make Greg break the hold. Greg Gagne going for the tag team title right now with this maneuver. Can he do it? The Animal.
Now, other than Ray, I don't know if the camera's to pick him up. Paul Ellering is suddenly back out here on the right side.
Paul Ellering!
trying to.
Chaos! Disqualification!
The road warriors. Oh, now wait a minute. The animal just ran Jim Brunzell into the ring post. Now it's three against one. All three. Going after Greg Gagne. Oh! Brunzell is out on the arena floor on the other side of the ring.
Now Paul Ellering putting his boot to the head of Greg Gagne. Greg Gagne bloodied up. Blood flowing from Greg Gagne. The Hawk looking over Jim Brunzell. Right down. Riders take off. Double clothesline on Brunzell.
Somebody's got to come in here and do something. It's
somebody
sick.
Get out here and stop this. Stop this. Look at Paul Ellering! Somebody stop this! Here comes Brian Jewell! Here comes Mark Zuboff! Here comes Tom Zink!
Buddy Lane is out here! Meanwhile, Ellering continuing to kick away at Greg Gagne. Kurt Hennig is in there now.
Here comes Larry the Axe. Blood all over Greg Gagne. Greg Gagne doesn't know where he's at. Greg Gagne blinded and half crazed. The other wrestlers trying to calm him down, tell him it's all over. I don't know what happened to Jim Brunzell.
Larry, I think he's out on the other side of the ring, laying on this floor here at the Winnipeg Arena. The Hawk had gone over and was just kicking him with everything he had while Brunzell was laying out on the other side. You could see in the right-hand corner of your screen a number of wrestlers administering, looking after Brunzell, who's still out on the arena floor.
Greg
Gagne in the ring, a bloodied mess. Wrestlers trying to contain him. Greg still has no idea where he is.
All right.
Now, here's where it all started. Gagne had the Hawk in the sleeper. You could see Ellery going up on the top rope. He's coming off the second rope with a jackhammer, if you will, in the middle of Greg Gagne's back. Now, giving the animal time, he comes back in. Now it's Ellery and the animal working on Jim Brunzell. They get him outside the ring. The Hawk, meanwhile, is coming too. Now, he and Ellery will go after Greg Gagne in just a minute. There, the animal ran Brunzell's head into the steel ring post.
I think it caught his shoulder more than anything else. I got a look at Jim Brunzell. He did not appear to be bleeding. Now here they come off and absolutely clobber Greg Gagne. I don't know what he hit him with, but he hit him with something besides skin and bone. Now look at this. This is Ellering stomping on Greg Gagne, and you'll see the blood flow here. They busted Greg in the back of Greg's head, also a cut. On the other side, Hawk working on. Now look at this kid. Absolutely. Now look at that. Mayhem. These people go insane. It's all over. They won't quit. Look at animal chewing on the cut of Greg Gagne. Now they're going to hold him. Incredible. And of course the Road Warriors disqualified, but of course that means that they get to keep the belt. Disgusting, but the Road Warriors are your winners.